on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things.
Christopher, in the braking zone, there's a little water running across the racetrack right there that locks up the rear tires coming across that braking zone into the chicane.
We know Ty Dillon got on those dry tires before everybody else, but give him credit, he drove up through the field before he put those tires on.
Right now, there is only one driver in the top 10 that's a part of the playoffs. Everyone else, non-playoff drivers, Ty Dillon wins stage one.
Cars knocked out.
See Clint Boyer in the 14 on the bottom, 47 of Stenhouse. Here comes Jimmy Johnson. Got the turn two. He just makes contact with that left rear of the 47. I don't know if Stenhouse had to check up a little bit when he caught the 42 or pinned it there, but just looking for me like
in the air. The sleigh bells are ringing and the carolers are singing while the air raid sirens blare.
Look at Hemric making it three wide in the middle.
Here comes Daniel Hemric. He's never won in NASCAR. He's up to second. He's never won in NASCAR. He's never won in NASCAR. He's never won in NASCAR.
He's never won in NASCAR.
You need to shut the fuck up.
Rick Hendrick being the businessman he is. I don't know if he's probably pulling up a little money because he just mentioned $129,000 extra. If Labonte should win. Labonte, oh! Who are you pulling for, buddy?
Probably don't care who wins as long as one of his cars wins.
By the way, the Unical bonus has never been won before in North Wilkesboro. Here's Jeff trying to get off the corner, but get position. And the lap are quickly going away.
There,
Jeff Gordon second. Dale Earnhardt finishes third, followed by Robert Presley and Sterling Marlin. And Kellogg's Corn Flakes crew celebrates Terry's performance. And there is Ray Evernham, the crew chief, on Jeff Gordon's car. Jerry?
I want him brought from his happy holiday slumber over there in Melody Lane with all the other rich people. And I want him brought right here with a big ribbon on his head. And I want to look him straight in the eye, and I want to tell him what a cheap, lying, no-good, rotten, four-flushing, low-life, snake-licking, dirt-eating, inbred, overstuffed, ignorant, blood-sucking, dog-kissing, brainless, dickless, hopeless, heartless, fat-ass, bug-eyed, stiff-legged, spotty-lipped, worm-headed sack of monkey shit he is! Hallelujah! Holy shit! Where's the Tylenol?
Hey y'all, it's racing day, so loud out here I can't hear a thing. Man, the fans are going wild. And these drivers came to rock, and no place else but Fox knows how to do it NASCAR style.
Boogity, 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 let's go racing, boys!
Hey now, here we go, race day. Don't you be going slow. Keep that pedal down on the floor. Push it to the crowd, can't take no more. Than there, set the flag game down.
Fine, I guess you are my little pog champ. Come here.
Jamie McMurray trying to fight their way through the middle.
You ever had your front wheel snatched off the ground?
No, thank you.
It's quite an experience, let me tell you.
Six laps complete this time by. 111 to go. Joe Nemechek has led all five laps, or six laps now, so far in the Aaron's 312. This started about 10 seconds ago, nine laps in, and there's the big one.
And I counted eight cars that just came down in front of us at the start-finish line.
That's all there is, about eight.
It's Johnny Sauter right here. Remember, he was in the big one a year ago. There you see Bobby Hamilton Jr., the 25 car. Jason Keller, second points, 57 car.
Lyndon Amick, we saw him waving.
And he was running in fifth place, Mike, Lyndon Amick.
What a shame.
Michael and Dale Jr. just barely made it through. It's right behind them.
Randy McDonald.
The Canadian driver.
There goes Scott Riggs. His car is just torn all up.
Chad Blunt crashed yesterday in practice. They repaired that car. And Darrell, this wreck happened at a place that we really don't normally see the big one, off turn four.
And this is Mike McLaughlin. A lot of damage to the front of his car, too.
Saw Todd Bodine, the 92 car, our points leader, sitting on pit road, tore up.
And the 38 of Casey Kane.
Outside post.
I see streaks of green.
Damage to the rear there.
Guys.
Red roses, too.
About 10 cars.
I ask you,
that's right, no. Those are American cars.
And I sing to myself.
Let's see.
What a wonderful world!
Come on, man.
That's the greens of green. That's red.
I think that may be
32 car, that's Linda.
I think that may have been behind. See, there's
a
little further back.
What a wonderful world!
Yeah, I think
he finishes since Daytona, but early problems. What do you see here as the 10 goes inside of the 22?
Yeah, 10's running low here. 22 slides up a little bit, gives him some room. 10 throttles up through the middle.
And, did he have a flat right front? He does. The 10 has a flat right front right there. You can already see it's down. That was a weird
skip it up and that up.
They'll be shopping, decorating, and plenty of snow. Hey, Patrick, who's that under the mistletoe?
Noah Gregson talking with Harrison Burton.
Pushing.
Now, crew members do arrive. Harrison not backing down here. And now, now they're really going at it.
Yeah, they are.